On July 17th, 2019, a fire broke out in Kyoto Animation's building. An insane man had broken into the office building and lit the entire place on fire while shouting out "die." I can't really find a legit source on the numbers, but a lot of people died, and it's honestly heartbreaking. Kyoto Animation is my favorite animation studio, creating work that honestly has shocked me in how truly beautiful an anime can be in both storytelling and animation. To honor the lives lost and to celebrate the hard work of Kyoto Animation, let's talk about the top 5 anime from the studio. At number 5, we have Clannad. Now, I'll be honest, Clannad is not my personal favorite here. While I absolutely love the character of Tomoya and his development as a character throughout the series, I didn't really care for Nagisa, and I was a smidge disappointed that he picked her when, like, the other girls had a lot more character, if I'm being honest.
Sorry, I just preferred the story when it was Tomoya focusing on moving on from his dead waifu while learning to be a single parent.
But it didn't really change that Clannad is still gorgeous, from its animation, absolutely incredible soundtrack, voice acting, and writing. Yeah, the ending is honestly a little Disney-ish with what, like, you know, the whole Deus Ex Machina reset thing, which felt really out of place with what I saw of everything-ish. But, I mean, it's still a great series. At number 4, we have Free. Is this an anime filled with nothing but questioning shirtless men getting soaking wet, being a fan service anime for anybody who's interested in men? Oh yes, absolutely. However, Free also has absolutely stunning animation. Not only do these boys look fine, but it's mostly the drawing of water that puts it here. I'm a big fan of gorgeous illustrations of water and ocean-themed stuff, and the water in Free is definitely equal to that of Ghibli water. I also like the story too, even if a lot of the story is misunderstanding, which sure is my favorite plot, but other than that, I think Free is great. At number 3, we have Miss Kobayashi's Dragon Maid. Not only is this art style absolutely adorable, but hilarious as well. Kana and Toru are hilarious characters, and it's just a sweet story about dragon girls adjusting to life as normal people instead of, like, murderous dragons. There's not much to say, other than it's funny, great animation, and as always, an absolutely lovable cast of characters, though Ravioli, don't lewd the dragon lolly. At number 2, we have A Silent Voice. Want a really good movie that's depressing but also hopeful? This gosh damn movie. While not the first story about a deaf character in anime, it doesn't take away the fact that it definitely helped spread awareness to learning to communicate with deaf people. Not just deaf either, it's honestly a movie about communicating, understanding others, and, you know, bullying is fucking gross. I think this movie also had one of the best redemption arcs for a character like Shoya. When normally, I absolutely despise a character who bullies and gets a half-assed redemption arc of,
"Oh hey, they're cool now, guys."
But with him, his development from an evil little shit to an absolutely sweet person blew my mind, and I ended up rooting for him at the end. This movie is just so beautiful in its storytelling, voice acting, and animation that I legit started crying when I got to the end. And now for number 1, the moment you've all been waiting for. Number 1, Violet Evergarden. I said it once in a Best Anime of 2018 video, but it still stays that Violet Evergarden is one of the best anime of all time. Not only is this animation absolutely breathtaking, that I would sit there in awe at every piece of scenery or shot of Violet's eyes, but the story genuinely moved me. I think at the end of the day, everyone has trouble empathizing with someone at some point. We all have someone in our lives that has a problem we can't empathize with, and it's this anime that brings back that reminder to empathize with other people. Not only that, but the stories themselves of this anime are so emotional that, well, I obviously cried. The episode that legitimately had me sobbing was episode 10. The ending was just so emotional, and I think was definitely the peak in the kind of storytelling that Kyoto Animation does. That would be it. Thanks for watching, everyone. Tell me your favorite Kyoto anime down below, and please consider donating to help the studio rebuild itself. Link to the official GoFundMe by Sentai Filmworks will be down below in the description, along with my other social media. As always, see you next time!